Welcome to the Strike Up Band Concert. Fourth grade has been learning our instruments for about 8 months. We have learned a lot. The fourth and fifth grade band students are combining for the first part of this concert. Our first piece is called Rolling Along. This is a familiar melody that is very similar to Mary Had a Little Lamb. We hope you enjoy.
Our second piece is called Lightly Row. This familiar melody uses a musical pattern just like Rolling Along. There are four small sections to this piece that follow an A, B, C, B form. That means you'll hear the same music during the B sections and different music during the A and C sections. We hope you enjoy.
Called A Mozart Melody in our lesson books, but you might know it as Twinkle Twinkle Little Star, The Alphabet, or Ba Ba Black Sheep. The rhythm we play fits to the words to Twinkle Twinkle Little Star. No matter what you call it, it is a familiar melody. This piece uses an A, B, A form. We hope you enjoy.
Our final piece for fourth and fifth grade is called High Adventure by Paul Lavender. You will hear each section of the band in charge of a different part that blends to make the piece. Not every part gets to play the melody, but each part is important to make this piece possible. We hope you enjoy.
is Audrey Yarrington, and I play the clarinet in the fifth grade band.
Hello, my name is Lucy Ronco, and I also play the clarinet in the fifth grade band.
Our first piece is called Alpha Squadron. It was composed by Greg Willis and was thought not known for sure may refer to the new mutants in the Marvel comics.
This piece could also refer to the military squadron in the StarCraft series. It features a percussion section and the wind instruments to help create a very exciting composition. Please enjoy Alpha Squadron.
My name is Phoebe Falzone, and I play the clarinet in the fifth grade band.
My name is Daphne Favoloni, and I play trombone in the fifth grade band.
Heard for the first time in theaters across the U.S. in 1977, this piece was written by the great composer John Williams.
Dr. Fanning remembers seeing the first Star Wars film three times in the first weeks after its release. He was a senior in high school.
With the popularity of the Star Wars franchise over many years, most everyone is familiar with this musical theme. May the Force be with you as you listen to Star Wars' main theme.
Thank you. Testing. Oh, hey. Hello, everyone. Thank you for coming. It's a little relaxed tonight. I'm not wearing a jacket and tie because the last time I did this concert, I almost died from heat. I mean, just, you know, so I'm much cooler. And so we're waiting for the bells. Not the bell to ring so much, but bells, concert bells, because we can only think of so many things to put out on the stage. And poor Gaetano. So the bells are coming. So let the bells toll. All right. Okay, I think we're ready. The first tune we do is something that's actually written by Wagner. And so, great opera composer. This is actually from one of his operas. And it's a challenging piece, especially as it gets to the end. It starts getting pretty high for the trumpets. Usually middle school trumpet players can't play those notes, but we got a couple guys back there that can. So I thought, well, let's do it. So anyway, this is Festival Procession by Richard Wagner. Thank you. Testing. Okay, the next tune, Incantation and Ritual, was written by a guy named Brian Balmages, and he's down in Florida, and he's a very popular composer for bands of this age group, as well as well above that in high school. This piece was actually commissioned for the East Stroudsburg School District, and so it's kind of fun. And this is a great tune, Incantation and Ritual. Don't you hate it when the band decides they want to take it much faster than you really wanted it to go? And it's funny because if you see me moving around on this, I'm trying to get in the view of, I asked them beforehand, I said, please try to remember to look up once in a while to make sure that we're all together. And so that's fun. It's one of the fun things of teaching middle school, but sometimes it happens at the upper school too. So it's just kind of, after 25 years, I'm like, yeah, whatever. But, you know, it's not always, you know, I look back there and there's that one music stand that was way up in front of the snare drummers who are, there's no way they're going to see me. But they had to put it up there because Mark then couldn't see the music from the bass drum, because the bass drum is two times bigger than the one he's used to playing in the middle school. So it's not his fault. He's like, hey, this thing's like, you know, a ton, well, just huge. So the next tune. Do we have another tune? Oh, this is one they really like. I bet we don't have a break drum. Do we? We're getting one, good. So please stand by. Do you need a joke? Okay. All right, this guy wants to, needs to talk to an attorney, and so he calls up an attorney's office and answers the phone and says, Smith, 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 and Smith. And he goes, could I speak to Mr. Smith? And he says, well, I'm sorry, he's not here today. He's not feeling well. He goes, well, how about Mr. Smith? And he says, well, he's in a meeting right now, can't talk to you. Okay, well, what about Mr. Smith? And he says, no, he's in court today, so there's no way he can talk to you. And he goes, well, I guess that leaves, can I speak to Mr. Smith? And he goes, speaking. Okay. How are we doing? Do we have it yet? Who's getting it? Okay, we're waiting for the break drum. It's actually an actual break drum from a car. And so it gets used in a lot of pieces for band, and middle school students suspect the percussionists, they love it. They love banging on the old break drum. This one's very heavy, it's very rusty. So there it is, see it? Hunter, hit it when you get a chance. Actually, Rain's gonna play it. I was gonna tell them that they use metal sticks, that it's even louder, but then I thought, nah, it's fine. Okay, this is a great tune. The students love this tune, and it's called, what's it called? Engines of Resistance. Thank you. We have three eighth graders. Michaela, right here in the flute section. Yes. Jason in the clarinet section with the white shirt. And in the trumpet section, red hair, Henry Brown. Okay, we have some special guests tonight. Mr. Riker is going to be playing baritone sax. Emma Derby is going to be playing bass. We have two eighth graders that have stayed up here on stage from the middle school band, and that's Michaela. She's over here. And Jason Cho over here. And then last but not least, we have an alumnus. If any of you have been here before over the years and stuff, he was in all of these concerts for, what, about 17 years? They held him back a lot. No, that's not true. But he has just finished up his freshman year at Messiah University, and Nico Colitas, helping out on the trombone. All right, so the first tune we're going to do is called Out of the Shadows, and it's I think you'll like it. It's an exciting tune. Thank you. Have any of you seen the Broadway show Wicked? Few people out there? I think it's a really great show. Saw it years ago, and it's incredible. I've loved it ever since. But this is just a medley of some of the songs that are in that show. And it's gonna, we have a set drummer back there. Yes, Caleb. And I hope you enjoy it.
Thank you.
Okay, it's time for some earth, wind, and fire. I have a special connection with that group because the trumpet player in that band for the last, I don't know, at least 15 years is an old college buddy of mine. And so we studied with the same trumpet teacher, and he obviously had some serious success. And so his name is Bob Burns, and so anytime he's in town, it's always fun to call him up, and he gets me tickets and backstage passes and all that, and it's a lot of fun. So this is a tune called September. You guys probably know it, or at least a lot of you will know it, not the youngest ones, but great tune, and this has also got everybody in it. Oh, yeah, we changed drummers. Enzo's back there now. We are now going to take just a very small break, short break. How are we doing on time? We've been doing this for an hour. I think we're making pretty good time compared to usual. I think the first time I did this strike at the bands thing, I think it lasted about 14 hours. I might be remembering that incorrectly, but it was a long show. And I always do it on Friday nights because I want to try to, you know, since it's not a school night. But unfortunately, tonight it's conflicts with a dance recital. So I'm missing a couple students for that. And you know how it goes. So, but we're going to bring out the piano and we're going to bring out some amplifiers. We're going to get loud. I hope you like that. We'll wake you up even more than September. And this is going to be the middle school jazz band, which we went to Hershey this last week, a week ago today. And We played for the adjudicators, the judges, and the one of the judges gave us a 93, which is actually a superior grade. But unfortunately, the other judge gave us a 87 or something. Anyway, so it came out 1 point under 90, which would have been superior. But so we missed it by just a little bit. But still, they sounded great, and they'll sound great tonight too. So just talk amongst yourselves. As I've said before, you know, I'll give you a topic. Rhode Island, it's neither a road or an island. Discuss. 1970, Van Morrison wrote this tune, Moon Dance. And so this is going to feature some solos. And if I can remember, it's going to start with Eris, is it? Eris. Are you listening? Are you first soloist? Okay, he's first, and then Henry in the back, and then Sophie on guitar, and last, Jasper on alto sax. Thank Emma Derby back there on bass, because I usually am standing up in front of this band trying to play the bass and make cues and do all that, and now I don't have to do that. And it's so much fun, because now I can clap and I can walk around and really enjoy the music, because usually I'm reading music and I'm going, oh gosh, I goofed that up. So thank you, Emma Derby, for being such an amazing musician. You know, she plays just about everything. She's an incredible violinist. She's also a great vocalist, as you will hear in our next group that plays. And what else do you do? Piano. Oh, she just does everything. She was in the show. She was in the musical. I mean, come on. Gee whiz. Yeah, she keeps, unfortunately, she's failed in her grades. And so, but the good news is that she gets to stick around next year. Wait a minute, I'm not going to be here next year. No, go ahead, graduate. Okay, here's a tune called Song for San Miguel. Thank you. Okay, we're missing a trumpet player who's probably ill. I think he wasn't feeling well. So he would normally have a solo on this, so we're gonna just not have that solo. This next tune, if you know the tune Sunny, I thank you for the, what is something? I never know the words. But I know the Sunny. You're just the craziest thing I've, okay. So anyway, this song is based on the chord changes of that tune, and it's got a different melody put over those chord changes. But when you listen to it, if you know that song from 1966, I think. So anyway, this is called Poco Loco, and it's gonna feature Shafiq on the trumpet. And Jasper again on the alto saxophone. Poco Loco.
Thank you.
the Middle School Jazz Band. Thank you. Okay, we'll let you guys go off to the audience, and we're going to bring out the Upper School Jazz Band quickly, and we'll finish this concert up. There's Luke. So Luke, you didn't get to make your first announcement. I know, and I didn't realize that Mr. Wallace had written one out for one of the kids. So you can make another one. You want to do something now? I don't care. We can do it now. Let's do it now. Ladies and gentlemen, senior Luke Piconi.
Okay, I wasn't really prepared for this right now. I would just like to take a second to thank Dr. Fanning as this, yeah. this is his last year with us as he is retiring and moving back to Michigan. and he's done so much for us and our community here at Moravian, from all the early morning band rehearsals with fourth and fifth grade, helping out with the pit here during the musical every year, and even starting our Moravian Academy pep band here at the upper school that plays through the basketball season. So, yeah. Yeah, so I'd just like to wish him a very happy and healthy retirement. So, yeah.
Thank you.
trades off with the drummer for four measures and then goes back and forth. And so that's a real common practice in jazz. And so that was not an arrangement. That was just the chords and the melody of that tune. And then everybody improvised. Now we get back to arrangements, our last two tunes. This is a Nora Jones tune that many of you may know because it was so popular, called Don't Know Why. And it's going to feature, again, Emma Derby, who's going to accompany herself on the piano and sing, because of course the rest of us are going to accompany her as well. So this is Nora Jones, Don't Know Why.
My name is Rob Riker. I teach music up here at the Upper School. And Dr. Richard Fanning is my colleague. He's been my colleague for 12 years. And I tell you what, there was a time, mostly before I met him, when I heard about him and I was scared. I was intimidated when you find out that the guy, oh yeah, he toured with the Monkees and, you know, Gary Puckett and Gap Band and, played on John Mellencamp's Scarecrow album and starts to be a little intimidating. And then somebody pointed him out at the opening faculty meeting, so I was like, he's really tall. And I was like, now I'm more intimidated. But then I met him. And this guy has been my colleague and friend for 12 years, and there hasn't been a moment that I thought, he's scary to anybody. He's thoughtful and kind. He's also a consummate musician. You know, he just looks at the hole and says, oh, I guess I got to play bass tonight. On top of he's a guitarist, he's a trumpet player par excellence, but plays in all sorts of varieties. And he has absolutely brilliant taste in music. He and I share some stuff from the 70s and 60s that are just like gems that have become part of our American songbook. Rich is just a man of great kindness, and I think the students would tell you that as well, that he is really thinking of them more often than he would think of himself. That's a little piece of his Midwestern upbringing, I think, a little piece of his just general aura of being very calm, very cheerful, and very dedicated to music. There's no question about that. But also, that was good timing, but also dedicated to the students here at Moravian. Has a tremendous bit of school spirit in him. And we'll see him at the, we would see him, maybe not this year, of course, but at the Red and Gold Games Day, he'd be out there with his trumpet getting, spurring everybody on to fight. And just that, between that and, of course, the pep band, there was a period, a few years where there was active mariachi going on up here. Rich, you bet you didn't know this, but Rich is an expert in mariachi and studied it in his graduate program. So there's a whole extra side of him maybe you didn't know. So this is a guy that we will feel upon his departure. We'll feel that we've lost something, we've lost someone special. But as the flowers would indicate, he's still here and we're giving him flowers. And so it's not like we've lost him. But here he is, Dr. Richard Fanning. If we could all just give him a round of applause. You're going to give him a Dr. Fanning. Thank you. I'm gonna read a very brief little poem that I actually memorized, but I'm nervous about trying to do it from memory, when I was in college. It's called The True Gentleman, and it's written by a gentleman named John Walter Whalen. I think it describes Rich Fanning to a T. So here we go, The True Gentleman. The true gentleman is the man whose conduct proceeds from goodwill and an acute sense of propriety, and whose self-control is equal to all emergencies, who does not make the poor man conscious of his poverty, the obscure man of his obscurity, or any man of his inferiority or deformity, who is himself humbled if necessity compels him to humble another, who does not flatter wealth, cringe before power, or boast of his own possessions or achievements, who speaks with frankness, but always with sincerity and sympathy, whose deed follows his word, who thinks of the rights and feelings of others rather than his own, and who appears well in any company, a man with whom honor is sacred and virtue safe. Rich, we wish you all the best, and we hope all that you'll stay in touch and let us know what gig you're on, what you're playing on, who you run into out there. We just want to know, we want to keep track of you. So all the best to you going forward for a restful and happy time moving back to Michigan with those beautiful grandchildren. Thank you.
stand. Our seniors, and then we'll go. Emma Derby. Please have a good weekend.